Hello and welcome to Without a Clue Wargaming. James here. Today is my first go at a painting tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to paint the Elite from the Halo Ground Command. I'm going to show you exactly how to get this. It's very easy, very simple. You don't need many paints. The only thing I will say is if you want to do the blue glowy effects, or the object source lighting as it's known, the way I do it, you will need an airbrush. But if you don't want to do that, you can just, I'll get to a point and then I will say from here on you will need an airbrush. But you could try, I've never tried it, but you could try and get this effect with just brushes. But yeah, I'm going to show you how to get to this standard. It's very easy, very simple. So these are the guys we're going to paint. With these, I've already taken Liberty and primed them in Chaos Black, or any black primer, and then after that I have then sprayed them with Lead Belcher. If you haven't got Lead Belcher as a spray can, you can just base coat it with a brush. Two thin coats of it out of the pot will get you to this same standard. I mean, we're painting the base anyway, so I'm not too fussed about it being on the base. So yeah, other paints you will need. I think it's Drucci Violet. That's how you get these purple guys. Caraberg Crimson is the other one you will need. This is what I used to do this Elite at the front here. Then you will need, oh my god, whatever this one is. That one. I can't pronounce it, but it's purple. And I use NATO Black from Vallejo Model Air to do all the black bits, but you could just use a Baden Black. Just any black paint will do. And then also the same with this one, I use Vallejo Model Air Silver. In place of this, you could just use Runefang Steel. Very similar, but all I'm doing is I just like these colours. This is you're just going to use for dry brushing, and this you're going to use to do all the black bits that you can see on this model, or the basically skin, but they wear a suit. So yeah, so I'll get set up and I'll see you in a minute. Hi, welcome back. Right, so we're going to paint this guy here first. So you need Drucci Violet, give it a good shake, and then you need a nice wash brush. This is just a cheapo pack of Humbrol brushes. All my wash brushes, I just use cheap brushes. So basically all you need to do is just cover the entire model in Drucci Violet, nice and easy. Every way that I paint, I always paint in a way that's very simple, that you can replicate over and over again. And yeah, so because I tend to paint models, or paint a couple models, then I go on to something else and I forget. So keeping things simple or writing things down helps you quite a bit when it comes to coming back to an army once when you want to add things to it. But yeah, so a nice heavy coat of Drucci Violet all over the Elite, including the gun, just cover the whole thing. I mean, if you want to do both of these guys purple, you're more than welcome to, but I'm going to show you two different ways of painting, well, two different ways that I paint the Elites. So that is the first coat of Drucci Violet. So give me 2 seconds and I'll be back with you in a minute. See you in a bit. Right, wash my brush out, nice clean water. Right, so on to the second guy while the other guy is still wet. This time I'm going to be using Caraberg Crimson, and same again with this guy, we're just going to cover the entire model in Caraberg Crimson. You don't need to be neat, it doesn't matter if it goes on the base, just literally cover the entire model Sorry if my hands get in the way, it's quite hard to paint around a camera. So nice and thick, well, say nice and thick, just make sure you give everything a real good coat. Just quickly check, make sure you haven't missed anything. I notice there's a bit of flash on this, but I'm not too fussed. And that's it, that's the first coat complete. So got the first coat on the purple guy and the first coat on this guy. So I'll let these dry and I'll be back in a bit. Okay, right. Off camera, I'll put another coat on these guys. So there's two coats of Caribou Crimson on this guy and Drucci Violet on this guy. And as you can see, over the lead belcher, you get a nice metallic purple and a nice almost red with this guy. So, onto the little details now. So, now I'm using my NATO Black, or you can use a Abaddon Black. So I'm just gonna put this on my palette. And then now you need, I use a Winsor & Newton 000. It's not very, it's a small brush, but it's not a very small brush. I also might use the Army Painter Psycho. I've just picked these up. I don't know if they're any good, I've not used them yet. So, but, okay. So, I've got my black. And now we're gonna do all the little details. So here, let's get a bit closer so you can see. I'm just gonna do the bit in between shoulder pads, the bit between the elbow, and then between the thigh and the groin. And the same on the other side. As I said, these are very, very simple to paint. I mean, very, very quick. Same again on the other side, and then you turn it around, and on the back there's a bit more to do. So you've got on the shoulders here, you can see there's a bigger area. I just literally cover this whole area, including under the armpit, and then on the elbow you want to keep that, this little bit here, you want to keep that the metallic color. And then on the back of the thigh, just coat that with a bit of the black. See, I'm not being too cautious, but yeah. So it looks like that. And then one last thing, I always forget to do this, it's just a bit across the back. And then just round the sides a little bit. And just do the same for the other side. Just do the elbow again. And that is pretty much it. So as you can see, you've got the black all around these bits. Oh. All round. So you've got the elbow, the shoulder, back of the torso, and just the back of the thighs. And that's pretty much it. So I do the same on the other guy. So this time there's a bit more armor plating on this guy because he is the commander, so he wears a bit of suit of armor. There's no bit to paint on the elbows on this guy. It's literally just behind the shoulders. Back of the torso again. Oh, get my fingers in the way. The back of the torso again. And the back of the thighs. So you don't have to be too, you have to be neat, but not too neat. I mean, I've gone over a little bit, but as these models are so small, you don't really notice it. So, and then same on the front. just do between the groin and the thigh. And then under the armpit. I don't know if I'm going to, yeah, I can. Just get down there. All right. Any other bit I've missed is the neck. So I just paint under the neck. Just like so, and then in the face. Because you can't really see these details anyway, so. And the back of the neck. Can't really get to the back of this guy, but that is all the black areas. So now it's dry and you can't really see it too much. Oh, I've missed a bit there, but that's it. So that's the black areas done, and you could almost just do the base, paint the sword blue, and you're ready to battle. So, but I'm going to take these a step further and I'll show you in a minute. See you in a bit. Okay, so now you need the Xerius Purple, I think it's called, but that's the name of it there. So you need a little tiny bit of this. And all you're doing with this is just painting the gun. So, the purple isn't far off the purple of the armour. So, I mean, I know in the game these are, some are blue, some are purple. It depends on the actual Xbox game. But I'm just doing mine purple because that's what I had at the time. Yeah, and that's that. So, for the power sword, if you're not going to use the airbrush, I'll quickly show you. So I use Magic Blue. I'm not quite sure what the equivalent Games Workshop paint is, but a little tiny drop of Magic Blue from Vallejo. And then all I will do, all I would do, is just paint the sword. Only paint the blades. And after this, if I would just edge highlight it white. If you haven't got an airbrush, then this is one way that you could do it. But personally, I think the airbrush just, the glow just adds a bit more to it. I mean, you could almost leave it like that, just paint the base, put your flock on the base and leave it at that. So, but that is a simple version of these guys. It's nice and simple. And then all that these have more than that is the airbrush. So from here on, I'm going to be using the airbrush. I'm just going to quickly, my base is, have I got it to hand? I just literally paint my bases in Mechanica Standard Grey and then dry brush it with some, I can't remember, I've got to find it. I think it's just a white, basically, it's just a greyish white. There is, oh no, Ceramite White. A really light dry brush of that and you get the base looking like this. So I'm going to paint the base, I'll get the airbrush ready and I'll be back in a bit. Right, welcome back. Right, to do the object source lighting that you see on this model here, the colours you're going to need are Magic Blue from Vallejo Game Air. Electric Blue from Vallejo again. And Dead White. So, right, starting with the Magic Blue. I will warn you now, it's going to get quite loud. I've got the air compressor here. Air compressor will be running. Mine's not too loud, but it might be quite loud on the microphone. So, headphone users, be aware. So, all I do, you really don't need a lot. I've just got a cheap airbrush from eBay. The compressor I use is an Expo. You just need a little bit of paint, literally. Couple of drops, and that should be more than enough. So just test it, make sure the flow is going well. I've got a bit of a leak in my airline as well, so you'll have to ignore that as well. But anyway, right, okay. All you need to do with this is basically pick where the light's coming from. So on this guy, the light, I'm just going to move the camera around a bit so you get a bit better light. So the light will be coming from the sword and the gun. You don't have to do the gun. If you're not going to spray the gun, just wash it in Nuln oil, and that'll be the gun done. But right, so the main source of light is going to be coming from the sword. So start off by airbrushing the sword. So, it's going to be hard to do on camera, but we'll give it a go. So, spraying the blue, I'm slowly working my way up the arm and then on the body. Because, as you can see, now the blue is going up the body. So, because you will get, like, especially like when you turn the light on, stuff around it glows. So, I'm just going to go down the leg a bit more. Go. And that's that side. So on the back side, do the same again. There might be a bit on his shoulder, but apart from that, there's not going to be much more. And then same again on the plasma carbine, you just from the middle and just work your way back. This won't be as much because it's not as bright. And then up the body again. So we're at this stage. So in the actual Xbox game, the swords are really, really bright, but the pistols aren't as bright. So I've just gone up the body a little bit here and then onto the face a little bit. But with the sword, I've gone quite bright and just brought it up. So we're done with this colour now. Oh, just chipped it a bit. So I'm done with this colour now. So I'll wash my airbrush out and then we'll be on to the next one. So I'll be back in a bit. Okay, so we're on to the next colour, which is Vallejo Game Air Electric Blue. So just again, a couple of drops. Right, so with this one, you want to go back over what you did, but you still want to leave a hue, like a little bit of the darker blue still showing. So I'll try to show you as best I can. So work your way from the tip. And onto the body. And same on the carbine. And the same again on the body. So you got something that looks like that. So done the whole sword, most of the arm, and you can't really see on the camera, but there's like a dark blue edge to it. But yeah, so that's the second stage. So the last final stage is using the dead white from Game Air. And basically you want to concentrate on the center of the gun, and mainly you go down the sword to his hand, and we may on this one just brighten up the body a little bit in the center just to make it pop just that little bit more. And yeah, I'll be back in a minute. All right, on to the next bit. So now we're using the dead white, and we're going to focus on the tip of the sword and work our way down. And then I'm just going to do a little bit in the center of the body. Just to lighten it up a little bit, just like that. And then center of the carbine. Same on the other side. And then same again on his body, just to lighten it up a little bit. And 2 seconds. And that is it. So all I need to do now is put the grass on, paint the edges, and then that's this guy done. So yeah, I'll finish him off camera. And then I'll post a picture. Airline just dropped to the floor. Yeah, I'll quickly finish him off camera, and then I'll be back in a minute. Right, so welcome back. All I did off camera was paint the edge black and put the static grass on. The static grass I use is from Warlord. It's the spring alpine grass. This comes with bits of cork in it. All I do is I sieve it. So I've got my metal sieve. I just pour this whole pot into the sieve and I sieve all the cork out, because then I use those for big scenery projects and things like that. But yeah, that's what I use. That's what this grass is. It's the same on all my models. So this is the one I showed you at the beginning that was all finished, and this is the one that we just completed. So as you can see, it's very, very simple. I know those of you that don't have an airbrush, this might be difficult, but I've had my airbrush 2 years now, and I use it all the time. They can be cheap, they can be expensive, it depends on how much you want to pay. Mine's cheap. All in, it cost me about 60 quid. So it's not too bad, and I use it for everything. But yeah, this is the completed item, so they look great. I'll throw some pictures up at the end of the video just so you can get a better view of it all. I've super glued and bloody flocked to my hands now, but yeah, I hope you like this. I hope it helps. It's the first video tutorial I've done, so if there's anything else, anything I can improve on. I know there's going to be, when I watch it back, there's going to be loads of stuff I've done wrong. I'm probably blocking the thing with the with my fingers on the camera. But yeah, if you like it, don't forget to like and subscribe. And we'll see you soon. Catch you later.